Hi everybody, and welcome back to another joyful story time. I know that we had a long break in between the last story time and this one, but hopefully everybody had a wonderful Easter, and hopefully this year you were able to spend much of your Easter with family, because I know last year there were so many of us that weren't able to do so. And since we are still technically in the Easter season, the book that I chose for today, I really wanted to read it before Easter, but it didn't come in time. So I'm reading it now, and it's about a rooster, and it touches upon that Easter message of birth, rebirth, and resurrection. And it's a wonderful and a beautiful story, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I did. Take care, and I'll see you next time. Petook, The Rooster Who Met Jesus, by Caryll Houselander and illustrated by Tomie dePaola. It was a lovely, warm day. The sky was bright blue, and the clouds white and thick like balls of cotton. Everything seemed full of color, big, happy colors like those in a picture book. Even the corn in the bowls was yellower than usual. Petook was happy. He had reason to be. He was a fine cock with snowy white plumage and a red comb that positively glowed in the sun, and today he had become the father of 12 little chicks. He thought that there were no chicks like them, none so round, so yellow, so fluffy, so bright-eyed. As for his wife, Martha, the brown speckled hen, plain and homely soul though she was, she had become all grand and important. During the past weeks, Petook had sometimes felt a little impatient. It seemed that Martha had some secret that he did not share. It made her very happy, but it also made her look almost smug. And it annoyed Petook to be outside of it. Martha had just sat on the eggs with a tiny smile on her face and her eyes nearly shut, as if she were looking into herself at a ball of light that was growing inside. Not talking, not moving, only making a funny little sound of happiness in her throat now and then. But now Petook understood. It was he who was smiling, and so bursting with pride and joy that he could not speak. Petook was sitting on the wooden gatepost, dreaming of his family, when a group of hens ran up to him. "Come," they clucked, "some stranger has been walking through the vineyard." Petook, who was as inquisitive as the hens, though he would not have liked it to be known, got up at once and hurried off with them. Sure enough, there on the dewy grass beneath the vines were the footprints of a child. They were set in a straight line toward Jerusalem, but Petook knew that between the vine and the road to Jerusalem was the chicken yard and Martha and the children. He began to fly in short bursts of flight back to his family. All the way he was saying to himself, "I am sure that they were a boy's footsteps, and boys are sometimes careless, even when they're not cruel. He might tread on one of the chicks." Petook could see that some of the fruit fallen under the vines had been trodden and crushed. When he got to Martha, he knew that he need not have been afraid. It is true that a boy was there, but this boy was kneeling by the little brown hen with a look of wonder on his face, quite spellbound by the lovely sight of Martha gathering the chicks under her wings. His hands, which were thin and golden colored, were spread out like protecting wings over Martha. His lips were slightly parted, his eyes shining. So rapt was he that Petook thought it must be the first time that he has seen a hen gathering her chicks. Martha, prouder than ever, was clucking softly and pushing the little ones in under her wings. Petook preened himself. He strutted up and down and around and around. He noticed every detail of the day, just as people notice every detail in a picture if it is rare and lovely, and one which they may not see again. He noticed how strong-looking the child's slim hands were, that the child's garment was woven without a seam, and that his sandaled feet were stained with splashes of juice from treading on fruit fallen from the vine. Suddenly, for sheer joy, Petook lifted his head and crowed. Years had gone by. Petook was quite old. He had just passed through an uneasy night. Everything had been steeped in moonlight, but all had looked strange and sad. He could see the distant hill of Calvary, where the three tall trunks always stood. Only when someone was to die did a trunk become a cross. For then the poor person brought the beam that was fastened across a trunk for him to hang upon. By getting on top of the dovecote and stretching his neck, Petook could just see the trunks as dark bars on the shining sky. It seemed as if morning would never come. Martha was sleeping on her eggs, and there was no one he could talk to. The moonlight made long, black shadows on the grass, and the grass was like pale green water. But suddenly, there came a break in the sky, and like a red wound, morning came. And suddenly, Petook crowed out loud and long, for he felt somehow excited and lifted up. He could not tell why. All day long, he kept returning to the dovecote and looking at the trunks. At about midday, or maybe a little after, Petook saw that there was a little smudge at the top of the hill, which he thought must be people. And then the crossbeam went up. When he saw it, he slowly opened his wings, for to him the cross looked just like that, like the opening of great wings. Of course, he did not know who was being lifted up there. He did not know that it was the lovely boy, or that the boy had remembered Martha and her chicks years later, and had said to hard-hearted men, "Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how often would I have gathered you under my wings as a hen gathers her chicks, and you would not." It was 3 days later, a morning cloaked with sunlight as with a garment of golden gossamer. Petook's dark mood had changed. He had a feeling that Martha's chicks would come out of the eggs today. It would be dawn in a few minutes, and the chicks would come. He felt sure of it. There was a soft step on the grass. It was the farmer's wife. She loved the chickens, and they trusted her. Now she knelt down by Martha, and the hen did not open her eyes, but made a soft gurgle of greeting in her throat. The woman put her hand gently under the hen's breast and drew out an egg. It was a lovely egg, a soft golden pink color, and it lay in the palm of the kind hand, warm and beautiful. The woman put the egg back, and then she leaned down. She was listening. Petook was listening too. So were the blades of grass and the drops of dew on them. So were the leaves on the trees and the stars that lingered still in the sky. The world was listening. Petook knew that. The trees everywhere were listening. All the winds held their breath. Every flower and leaf and bird was still. It was so quiet that Petook heard the chicks and the eggs tapping softly with their beaks to get out. Yes, Petook heard that, and he heard life everywhere tapping softly, knocking softly to get out, to come out of the dark into the light, out of silence into sound, out of death into life, bird and beast and seed in the earth and bud on the tree. Petook heard all that when the chicks tapped to get out. And suddenly one of them came, a struggling splutter of gold fluff. The woman laughed, and the sky broke into a splendor of light. Petook threw back his head and crowed and crowed and crowed. His red comb burned in glory, the white feathers in his plumage dazzled in the light, and the new chick danced at his feet. He crowed again and again and again. It was Easter morning. The end.